Hello everyone, welcome to days 18th of January LeetCode challenge, and today's question is maximum number of k sum pairs. So you need to, you are given an input array and you need to count the maximum number of pairs whose sum is equal to k, and you cannot reutilize the same index more than once. So let's walk through the example. The example says you are given an input array of 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, and the sum that you are searching for is 5. There are two pairs that can be formed, 1 plus 4 and 2 plus 3. And the total such counts is 2, and you return 2. Similarly, in this case, there's only one pair possible, 3 plus 3. Once you consume this 3 and this 3, or this 3, either one of them, you cannot create more elements with whose sum is equal to 6, and the answer is 1. So let's walk through the algorithm now. We have done similar questions in the past, and we'll be using the same technique now. It's just an extension to those approaches. So let me just talk about the first approach. The first approach that strikes my mind when I read this question is to the two-pointer approach. First of all, go and sort the input array, something similar to what I have done here. So the array here is already sorted. It can be any permutation of the array. And let's use the two-pointer approach. You take a first pointer here, the second pointer here, and you check what calculate the sum. The sum of these two elements is 6. And what we are searching for is 5. It is higher than 6. It is higher than 5. So what you'll do, you'll reduce the end pointer. Since it is higher, you'll reduce the end pointer. End pointer comes here. And this is the start pointer. And the sum recalculated 1 plus 4 is 5, which is equal to the intended sum. You found one pair. Increment the answer count and increase the start pointer. Start pointer comes here, reduce the end pointer. End pointer comes here. So end pointer is this 3. So 1 plus 3, you get 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 is less than what we are searching for. What we are aiming for is 5. So we'll increment the start pointer. Start pointer comes here. So now 2 plus 3 is again 5. We found one pair, reduce both of them. So reduce both of them, it merged and you break the condition. A pretty simple approach. If the sum is greater than k, reduce the sum. How will it reduce the sum? Reduce the end pointer, end minus minus. If the sum is less than k, what you will do? You increase the sum. How will you do that? Start plus plus, increment the start pointer. And in case the sum gets equal to the intended value that we are searching for, which is k in this case, consume both the indexes, end minus minus and start plus plus, and increment your answer count. That's it. So first approach, pretty simple. Time complexity is order of n log n because of the sorting part, and what we are operating on is the sorted array in a linear fashion, and hence the total time complexity becomes n log n. Not a very good approach, but yeah, it's somewhat doable for the contest. But definitely the interviewer will gonna ask you the other approach as well, where you'll need to use the map. Similar to what we use, the question says, you need to identify such instances where sum of two elements turns out to be equal to k using a map. How can you do that? Similar kind of an approach. We have done it in the past, repeating the same things again. So you start iterating the map, the elements in the map. Remember, you need to sort the map, sort the array. So you found one at 0th index. So you count its frequency, so what's the frequency there in the map? The frequency of 1 is 1. Now you move ahead. The frequency of 1 becomes 2. And you also check whether, the other element that you're searching for, k minus the current element is 1, it exists in the map or not. The k minus the current element exists in the map or not. If it does, you consume that. You consume that element and you reduce the frequency of that existing element and get it done. So let's iterate. So we added 1, 1, then the frequency turns out to be 1, 2, and 5 minus 4 doesn't exist in the map. You move ahead, then you get 2. So you add 2, 2, 1. It doesn't exist, like the frequency, the 3 doesn't exist. 5 minus 2 doesn't exist in the map. Move ahead. Then you get 2 again, so frequency gets updated. 5 minus 3 doesn't exist in the map. Move ahead. then you witness three. So you get three, and one variable is three. So you'll not add three because 5 minus 3 exists in the map. Since 5 minus 3 exists in the map, you will consume this three, and you'll reduce the frequency of one of the variable, one of the frequency of this two. So this frequency gets reduced to one. So one element is picked up this one, and other element is picked up this one. You'll not add this into the map because it is getting consumed, and you'll move ahead in the counter. Also, you'll increment the answer count by one. And you move ahead, you witness four. 5 minus 4 is one. One exists in the map. Cool. We found another candidate. So you'll use one element as this, and you'll reduce the other possibility as this. So this frequency also gets reduced to by one. And then you move ahead, and you witness five. Also, you'll update the answer count since you found two such instances, and you get five. Five doesn't 5 minus 5 is 0. 0 doesn't exist in the map. You'll simply add 5, 1 into the map. Iteration is completed. The output, the answer count is 2. We are good. We'll quickly code both these approaches, and let's get it started. Using the approach one, the first step is to sort the array. Arrays dot sort nums, and we'll take two pointers, start and end. Pretty simple, the regular technique. And we'll take another variable, the count variable, which is 0, initialize to 0. All good so far. While start is less than end, if let's calculate the sum. Integer sum. Sum would be equal to nums of start plus nums of end. If sum is greater than k, that means you are too much on the left part. End minus minus. Otherwise, if sum is less than k, that means you want to increase the sum. So start plus plus. Else, that means now sum is equal to k. I'm not writing that condition because it doesn't make sense. We found one instance, end minus minus, start plus plus, and count plus plus. This looks awesome. Return count. Let's try this up. Finished. Oh, sorry. Nums will be initialized with the last. My bad. I think I'm in a hurry. Awesome. Accept it. Let's talk about the second approach that we discussed, time complexity in log n because of the sorting part, and space complexity of constant space. And let's talk about the other part of the question. Let me just comment this up, and let's solve it using the map technique. The map technique says define a map where the key would be the element itself, and the what would be the frequency. New hash map, and let's create another variable for storing the count, and let's iterate through the map. Integer el over the map array, the nums array, and let's check if map dot contains key. Which key are we searching for? K minus CL. If that exists in the map, let's consume that. Map dot get K minus EL. So this would be the frequency. One frequency, and what we need to do, if frequency is equal to one, that means we are consuming it, so just remove this element from the map. Remove k minus el, and otherwise, if it is greater than 1, that means then map dot put k minus el comma frequency minus 1. Sounds good. Also, let's update the count variable. Also, we are not storing the EL in this case. Otherwise, because one element is what we have consumed here, k minus EL, and other element is EL itself. Otherwise, we'll put this entry in the map, EL comma map dot get for default EL comma 0 plus 1. And once we are done, return the count. Not very difficult. I'll rate this question somewhat in between of a easy and a medium question. Looks good. Accepted. I hope this part is clear to you guys. Whenever a map doesn't contains other key, we are updating this information in the map because we cannot consume the current index. Otherwise, we are consuming the current index, the current EL element, and k minus EL element that was there in the map that existed. Pretty easy to understand. The time complexity of this approach is order of n. Since you are iterating the elements again once, and the space complexity is again order of n. Let's take the case where all elements are independent, are distinct, and they get entry into the map. And you may find a valid matching pair or not. The size can go up to n. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it.